Lewis, it's been 12 months since we last spoke to you. You haven't aged much. Oh, Trump must be looking after you.
In the best sort of ways, yeah, I think they are.
Good, good. We're here at the Open House. One of the interesting new innovations is what we have here. Can you just tell us, for our audience, what this is and what it's used for?
So what we have is the Partmaster with the LiftMaster Compact. And the way it works is the LiftMaster Compact is used to load and unload sheets on and off of the machine onto the pallet changer. And the Partmaster takes the finished sheets and brings it down to the operator, so he's able to unload it in a much easier manner than he would if he had to get the entire sheet off of the bed instead.
So the LiftMaster isn't new, but the Partmaster is?
The Partmaster is. It's new for us. It's been around for a little while, at least a few years now, but it's just something new we're showing to people because I think the big focus now for everyone is automation. The machines have achieved a certain speed whereby people are trying to keep up with them. So if you want to run lights out or without people manning the machines, production is the way, automation is the way forward.
You still do need to have an operator here at the bottom though to take the finished parts off.
You do. But what you're able to do is, if you see on the top there, there's another table. So during nighttime, if you were to run without an operator, you can still stack up on that top table. So although an operator is needed during the day, you are able to run without someone else there as well.
Okay, what about the LiftMaster itself? What's the sort of maximum weight of sheet that you could have, or thickness of sheet you could...
So the LiftMaster Compact we have is limited to either 25 mil or 900 kilograms, whichever one comes first. The unloading part for the Partmaster is limited to 12 millimeters though, that's the only thing.
Okay. And can this be adapted or integrated to any of your laser cutting machines? I mean, here we're operating with a 3030, but could it go on the 5030 machine?
Yeah, it can go on the 5030 as well. The only ones it won't go on is the 2030, and that's because of the style of pallet changer, whereas these ones come in from the back. The 2030 has like a side loader, what they call a side loader. So yeah, it wouldn't work with that one.
And you've got six sensors here as well then, so I'm assuming you can't go into the area while it's moving?
No.
What is, full and health and safety compliant.
Of course. It's like an infrared sort of curtain, if you like. So as soon as that barrier is broken, all of that area stops. The machine will continue cutting because that's not affected, but all of the moving area outside the back will stop.
So there's two markets for this. Is your existing customers that have machines, and there's also people that are buying new machines that can add this to it?
Yeah, of course.
And for you, is this one of the big highlights here at the show?
I mean, I would say so, because it enables you to do much more with the machine in terms of getting it off and utilizing your operators fully. But I mean, there's so much more technology available in the machines now. I think this is, it's just a nice feature. It's a nice feature to have.
And in terms of the machine itself, has there been many developments on the 5030 or the 3030 in recent times?
I mean, it's nothing that has been released yet, but I know in the coming months they're talking about releasing like a 10 kilowatt laser and things like that. High speed eco is going to be introduced to the 3030 from what I understand. So I know there are things in development, but they like to keep it quite hush-hush.
Okay, well, let's hope you don't age, well, equally don't age in the next 12 months. Thank you, Lewis.
I'm hoping so. Thanks very much. Cheers.